वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डील विद चैप्टर नंबर 4, एनिमल किंगडम पार्ट 1। इन दिस वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द बेसिस ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एनिमल्स। सो वी नो दैट देर आर अ डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ एनिमल्स इन द अर्थ, देर आर मैनी वराइटीज ऑफ एनिमल्स कंपेयर्ड टू प्लांट्स। सो हाउ कैन दे बी क्लासिफाइड? So animals are classified according to certain features which may be common between them. The first is arrangement of the cells, how the cells are arranged, body symmetry, so what is the shape of the body, nature of coelom, so how the body cavity is present or not, or what is its structure, digestive system, circulatory system and reproductive system. So these systems are considered for classification. The first category is levels of organization. So there are different levels of organization of cell. The simplest is cellular level. So at the cellular level, there are many cells. They are grouped, but they function independently. Example is sponges. So this is the cellular level. Now the cells are grouped and they function uniformly and they form a tissue. So it is the next level as found in coelenterates. The main member is hydra. The tissues combine to form proper organs like the stomach, lungs. This is called organ level and it is included in platyhelminths or flatworms. The organs combine to form organ system like digestive system, nervous system, circulatory system, and this is the highest level of organization. In this, annelids, which involve earthworm, up to chordates, which involve mammals. The digestive system are of two types, incomplete. So incomplete, it does not have a two openings. It has only a single opening to the outside, and this opening is used both as mouth and anus. So food enters from this opening as well as the waste material is released out. Example are platyhelminths or flatworms. In complete digestive system, there are two openings, mouth for entry of food and anus for ejection of waste material. Example are arthropoda. Arthropoda involve insects like cockroach. Now the circulatory system are of two types, open type. In open type, blood is pumped out of the heart and cells and tissues are directly bathed in it. So heart pumps the blood, but the blood does not flow into vessels. It flows around the cells and tissues. So they are continuously dipped inside the blood. The spaces are called sinuses. Example is arthropoda. In closed type, which is found in developed animals, the blood is circulated through vessels. So the heart pumps the blood and it enters the vessels, artery, veins and capillaries. Example is annelida, which involves earthworm. The second criteria is symmetry. So symmetry means equality. Asymmetry, A means absent. So in some animals there are no equal parts, or the body cannot be divided into equal parts. So any plane that passes through the center does not divide them into equal halves. Example are porifera, which are irregular in shape. Radial symmetry. So any plane passing through the center axis divides the organism into two identical halves. So if any line is passed through the central axis of body, it divides the animal into two equal halves. Example are coelenterates, which involve hydra, ctenophores, which are aquatic animals, and echinoderms, which involve starfish. We know that starfish is shape of the star and it can be divided into five equal parts along the radius. Here we can see two diagrams. The first is radial symmetry. In hydra, we can see it can be divided into many equal parts along the radius. And in the lower part, we can see a crab. A single line divides the body into two equal halves. It is called bilateral symmetry. Here we can see the third type of symmetry is bilateral. Body can be divided into identical left and right halves only in one plane. So only one line can divide it. Example are annelids and arthropods. The third category is diploblastic and triploblastic organization. So di means two. Here the cells are arranged in two embryonic layers. The outer layer is ectoderm and the inner layer is endoderm. In between these two layers, undifferentiated layer of cells is found, which is called mesoglia. Example are coelenterates. Now in triploblastic condition, which is more developed, there are three layers of cells. Tri means three. The developing embryo has a third layer called mesoderm between ectoderm and endoderm. So there is a third layer. Example are platyhelminths or flatworms and all the higher groups up to chordates, which involve man. In this figure we can see a diagram. In a diagram there is diploblastic condition. In the diploblastic condition there are only two layers, so we can see ectoderm and endoderm. In between there is no fixed layer, only undifferentiated cells are present, which are called mesoglia. And in the B figure we can see ectoderm, endoderm, and between there is mesoderm layer, so they are called triploblastic. Now the next basis of classification is coelom. It is a cavity between body wall or the outer wall and gut wall. Gut means the inner part, which involves alimentary canal and the pathways. So we can also say that it is a body cavity which is lined by mesoderm. This definition is very important, that body cavity which is lined on outside as well as inside by mesoderm, it is called coelom. So coelomate animals which have a coelom, they are called coelomate. Example are earthworm. Pseudo means false. So pseudo coelomate, body cavity is not lined by mesoderm, and if mesoderm is present, it is in the form of scattered pouches. Many bag like structures are present, but not a single cavity is present. Example are Aeschylminthes or roundworms. Acoelomate, in these body cavity is absent. Example are platyhelminths or flatworms. So here we can see three diagrams. In the first there is coelom. A coelom is present, lined by mesoderm on outside as well as inside. Next is pseudocoelom. We can see pouches are present. And in the third we can see acoelomate. In this there is no cavity present. The next category is segmentation. So the body is externally and internally divided into many segments, and the segments are called metameres. So here the segments may be many. For example, there are more than 100 segments in earthworm. So some organs are repeated, means there are multiple of organs. For example, there may be 3 pairs of testes or 2 pairs of ovaries. This segmentation is called metameric segmentation, as found in earthworm. The next criteria is notochord. It is a rod like structure which helps in support, and it is derived or formed from mesoderm of embryo. It is found on the upper side of body, which is called dorsal side. Now animals are of two types according to notochord. First are chordates, in which notochord is present. So it is present at least in some stage of life. Example are mammals. Non-chordates, in these notochord is absent. It is never present. Example are porifera up to echinoderms. So all the lower groups, they do not have chord. Here we can see according to the properties how the animals have been divided. First, kingdom Animalia, it is multicellular. They are of two types, cellular level, which involves cell, tissue, organ and organ system level. Now in cellular level only porifera are found. In tissue, organ and organ system level, there are two main symmetry, radial and bilateral, because asymmetry was in only porifera. In radial symmetry, we can see coelenterates and tenophora. In bilateral, where two parts can be obtained, there are acoelomates, in which platyhelminths are present. They do not have a body cavity. False coelom, in which pouches are present. Example are roundworms. And true coelom, which is the most developed group. It involves annelida, in which earthworm is found. Arthropoda, in which cockroach is found. Mollusca, in which shells are found. And octopus is also a member of this group. Then echinodermata, in which starfish is there. Hemichordata, in this balanoglossus, an animal, it is found. And chordates, which involve fishes, birds, reptiles and mammals. So these are the groups. We can see that the simplest group occupies the first phylum and the most complex group occupies the last phylum. Okay, children. So this was the basis of classification of animals. Thanks.